अबाउट द मॉडल द जीएलपीपी. जीएलपीपी मीन्स जनरल लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम और मॉडल इज एज फॉलो. मैक्सिमाइज और मिनिमाइज जेड इज इक्वल टू सी वन एक्स वन प्लस सी टू एक्स टू प्लस सी थ्री एक्स थ्री प्लस टू वन प्लस सी एन एक्स एन. सी द नेक्स्ट पेज. सब्जेक्ट टू द कॉन्स्टेंट्स ए वन वन एक्स वन प्लस ए वन टू एक्स टू प्लस वन प्लस ए वन एन एक्स एन ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू और लेस देन इक्वल टू और इक्वल टू बी वन. A21 x1 plus A22 x2 plus 1 plus A2n xn greater than or equal to or less than or equal to B2 and so on. AM1 x1 plus AM2 x2 plus 1 plus AMn xn greater than or equal to or less than or equal to BM. This set of equations we call as 2. Also, there are non-negative restrictions. X1 greater than or equal to 0, X2 greater than or equal to 0 and so on. Xn greater than or equal to 0. It means all the decision variables are non-negative. The first is called an objective function, which was maximize or minimize z. The second are called linear constraints. And the third one are non-negative restrictions. This is basic model for a general linear programming problem. Sometimes this type of questions will be asked in your examination. Write the general linear programming problem. So you write all these things. Above model can also be written. In short, we can write them as maximize or minimize z is equal to summation over I is equal to over j is equal to 1 to n cj xj. This is our objective function. Subject to the constraints, summation j is equal to 1 to n aij xj greater than or equal to or less than or equal to bi, I is varying from 1 to m. These are our linear constraints and non-negative restrictions. Xj greater than or equal to 0, j is equal to 1 to so on n. This can be written in short. Where here x1, x2, so on, xn, they are decision variables. C1, C2, Cn, they are per unit profit or cost of decision variables. Aij is equal to the amount of resource I consumed per unit of variable xj. Bi is equal to the total availability of the ith resource. Let us see again. One more example. We also have one more example. So to form a model, we should first identify the decision variables carefully. This is very basic concept. Second, formulate the constraints. Constraints means linear constraint, non-linear, and also non-negative restrictions. And formulate the objective function. Keep this in your mind. After seeing this example, I will return to the first page, then you write. It is very easy example, but see it carefully. A manufacturer produces two types of products, A and B. And do tarah ka product banata A or B, and sells them at a profit of rupees 3 on A and rupees 4 on product B. Product A par 3 rupay ka profit, product B par 4 rupay ka profit. The products are processed on two machines, M1 and M2. Two machine M1 and M2 hai, us pe is product A or B ko le jaya jata hai, process kiya jata hai. Product A requires 2 hours and on M1 and 3 hours on M2. Jo product A hai, M1 machine pe gaya, to wahan usko 2 ghante lagte hain processing mein, aur M2 machine pe gaya, to 3 ghante processing mein lage as processing time. Whereas B requires 1 hours and 2 hours respectively on M1 and M2. जबकि प्रोडक्ट बी के लिए 1 घंटा और 2 घंटा लगता है मशीन M1 और M2 पे. The machines M1 and M2 are available for not more than 8 and 10 hours respectively. मशीन M1 8 घंटे से ज्यादा के लिए नहीं है और मशीन M2 18 घंटे से ज्यादा के लिए नहीं है on any working day किसी भी दिन. Formulate the problem mathematically as LPP. इसको मैथमेटिकली फॉर्मुलेट करना है. इसका सॉल्यूशन देखो. सॉल्यूशन में क्या किया, फर्स्ट कॉलम में दे दिया प्रोडक्ट्स ए एंड बी, इन सेकंड कॉलम मशीन्स एम1 एंड एम2, एंड इन थर्ड कॉलम प्रॉफिट. देखो प्रोडक्ट ए के बारे में मशीन एम1 पे प्रोसेसिंग टाइम 2 घंटा, एम2 पे प्रोसेसिंग टाइम 3 घंटा, ये पीछे तुम्हारा दिया है 2 आवर्स ऑन एम1 एंड 3 आवर्स ऑन एम2, और बी के लिए है 1 आवर एंड 2 आवर. प्रोडक्ट बी के लिए 1 आवर ऑन M1 एंड 1 आवर 2 आवर ऑन M2। अब प्रॉफिट प्रोडक्ट ए के लिए प्रॉफिट हो रहा है ₹3 पर यूनिट और प्रोडक्ट बी के लिए प्रॉफिट है ₹4 पर यूनिट। और मशीन M1 है वो 8 घंटे से ज़्यादा नहीं है, मशीन M2 18 घंटे से ज़्यादा अवेलेबल नहीं है। सो नाउ द डिसीजन वेरिएबल्स विल बी लेट X1 X2 इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स ए एंड बी प्रोड्यूस्ड डेली। मान लेते हैं कि X1 है प्रोडक्ट ए का नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स डेली प्रोड्यूस्ड एंड X2 इज नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स बी प्रोड्यूस्ड डेली। देन व्हाट विल बी आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन? आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन विल बी टू मैक्सिमाइज दिस प्रॉफिट। सो वी हैव X1 यूनिट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट ए, सो प्रॉफिट ऑन X1 इज 3x1 एंड ₹4 पर यूनिट प्रॉफिट ऑन प्रोडक्ट बी, सो प्रॉफिट ऑन प्रोडक्ट बी विल बी 4x2। सो द टोटल प्रॉफिट विल बी 3x1 प्लस 4x2। सो आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन विल बी मैक्सिमाइज दिस दैट इज इक्वल टू 3x1 प्लस 4x2। सिंस टोटल प्रॉफिट इज X1 into 3 plus X4, X2 into 4. Next, see the about the constraints, linear constraints. Time constant on M1 is equal to 2X1 plus 1X2 less than or equal to 8. Since 2 on product A and 1 hour on product B, but M1 is available for not more than 8 hours. So 2X1 plus 1 into X2 less than or equal to 8. This is one constant, and second constant on M2, 3x1 plus 2x2 less than equal to 18. Since F2 is not available for more than 18 hours, and 3 hours for product A, and 2 hours for product B. So this is our second linear constant. Thus, obviously, x1 and x2 both should be greater than or equal to 0, since number of units cannot be negative. Thus, the model will be as under. Maximize z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2. This is our objective function. Subject to the constraints, 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 8. This is on M1. And 3x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 18. It is on M2. And x1 greater than or equal to 0. x2 greater than or equal to 0. This is our non-negative restrictions. So this is all about our modeling of the given problem as LPP, means linear programming problem. We have used the general linear programming problem method or model. Similar example is there. I think you can solve it, but I have given some hint also. You have time, so please see it also. Example, a company sells 2 products A and B, making a profit of ₹40 and ₹30 per unit respectively. The production process, a total capacity of 3,000 hours. The production process has a total capacity of 3,000 man hours. One unit of A requires 3 hours and one unit of B requires 1 hour to produce. The company officials know that the maximum number of units to be sold in the market are 8,000 units of A and 12,000 units of B. Formulate this as an LPP model to maximize profit. So see the hint. Maximize Z is equal to 40X1 plus 30X2, 40 rupees and 30 rupees. So it is 40X1 plus 30X2. First you write decision variables X1 and X2. Subject to the constraints, 3X1 plus X2 less than or equal to 3000. And X1 is less than or equal to 8000. It is given 8000 units. And X2 is less than or equal to 12,000 units. Means maximum of units of B is 12,000, maximum units of A is 8,000. And obviously, two non-negative restrictions are X1 greater than or equal to 0 and X2 greater than or equal to 0. So this is a simple example. You can solve it very easily. After this, I will move to transportation problem. So you can you write it, all of them. And if you feel any difficulty or problem, raise your hand and ask me the question. These are very easy ideas, so you can solve them.